ready, Eva?
I am.
Go.
I'm going to talk to you all about something that every one of you should know about as good Brits, and that is the fiber of our lives, the wool, the sheep, wonderful animals that dot our countryside. Now, this is a newborn lamb. They are born that way with that fine layer of wool. And then we go from that to this. I could have sold a lot of these tonight, I think. But this is actually alpaca, not lambs. But we'll be talking about wools, fibers, and all the wonderful animals that make these up. And not only the garment itself, but the spiritual part behind it. This is what we usually think of as a sheep. White, kind of dirty, got flies in his ears. The picture was taken by Adrian's wall. But there is much more than just that type of sheep. This is a Herdwick sheep. Have people seen these? Lake District? These are well known for helping the ecology of the Lake District. You can see that as a natural coloration for them there, the way that wool changes. Here's a baby. I just thought he was cute. So this way, this wool, though, it's very fine, different grades of wool. And this particular wool is often used more in carpets and insulation. It's not typically used for hand knitting like we saw with that hat. Now, on the other hand, this guy, that is Blue-Faced Lester. If you really want to impress a knitter, ask her about BFL. If you really want to get her excited, tell her you know where she can find some BFL. It's like cocaine to knitters. The black sheep there was just an example of a black sheep to show that sheep can be that black. This guy is a Wensleydale long wool. He's nearby. We can see him here in Yorkshire. And he makes that pillow, as you saw there. This is my favorite. This is an alpaca. Three little baby alpacas. You can see the head top there, one of them. These are great little animals, and they do very well in Britain, though they are native to Peru. The thing about these is that you get a herd of alpacas, the chief alpaca finds a place to poo, and they all poo there. It's brilliant. So they make great, you know, you need at least three to make a happy herd, but you can have them somewhere in your larger gardens around here. So we go from these wonderful animals to this wonderful little, at least one little balls of yarn. These are sometimes fondly called as donuts. And I put some different colors up there. And this is what you start with as a knitter to start making your objects. You can also work with something called this yarn bowl. You can see it's got a little slit for your yarn, holes to stick your needles through. Also all helps you into the mystical magic what it is to work with this wonderful, wonderful material. So when you're working with something like this, the cute little stitch markers keep your place as you're doing cables. But there's just something about how it feels as it goes through your fingers and the rhythm of your needles as you're knitting. Knitting has been used in anger management, it's been used in prisons, it's been used with depression and anxiety. There's something about the way that you work with this wonderful fiber that just does marvelous things for your brain and your spirit. This is an example of crochet being something else you can do besides knitting with your yarn. And this is fast. I was amazed how fast crochet was. Here's another example of crochet. I make these little baskets. And so when you really need a quick fix, because knitting is slower than crocheting, and you have peace. This is another display of hats here. This is a combination of actually knitting and Tunisian crochet, which you do with a very long hook. And it makes you look very, so you're doing stuff, and people come up and say, oh, you're knitting like new. I'm doing Tunisian crochet. Can't you? That is a really great way to make friends. This I took a picture of simply because I like the way it looked, this particular hat, and of course, a little pom-pom is just a lot of fun to make. And of course, this is what was I had on the PSA Yorkshire website, the cat hat with furry ears, the way that you can use your imagination to make things. This was something that I just figured out. My niece wanted it. I had no pattern. I just came up with my own there. These also are similar with little fingerless mitts, because making all those little fingers gets very boring, so I try to convince people that this is actually a good thing for them to have. I tell them you can text so much better with it, you know, fingers in, so they're free. But then I like to finish with this lovely little sheep, again, I don't know what breed he is, in the purple heather, the fiber of our lives here, especially in the UK, the beauty of the sheep.